Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the 10th video of the Script Manager how-to. With the last video we had a closer look about the to-do actions implementation, and with this video we will have a closer look about the description, how the description is handled with the script elements. The to-dos we did already, now the description is the next part. So there is the standard functionality. We just display the description text, which is part of the tiddler. Yeah? So this is the description field, which contains this information. If I remove it, the field, then it should display, let's say, a default text, which says no description defined yet. Click the edit button to define it. Either this button, or you can also click this button and then define it. Then we have the cancel button, which just cancels the input, and the OK button. Now the field is set again. So that's the functionality. Yeah. So if we click the action button, it should display the edit input and a cancel and a OK button. So let's have a closer look about the code. So first of all, there is the description tab, which just transcludes the list description template. Yeah. The important thing here is these two pipes at the very beginning, which is a shortcut for use this tiddler as a template, which means it doesn't set the current tiddler variable. Because in this case, the current tiddler variable would be this description or this text. Yeah? If we use it as a template, it uses the current tiddler variable from the tiddler, which contains the element. Okay, so let's have a look at the list description template. And no, this is the wrong one. List description template, this one. Close all the other stuff and open the source code. As we can see at the bottom, there is the call, and it creates a div which has a class script description grid. Yeah? And this is the same construction as we had already with the fourth video. So if you have a look at the layout and CSS stuff, then you'll see how this works. Then it opens a new link row, which is this one. The new link row has a table header and text index text template. The header is here, which is just two spans. There is the description and the action, yeah, as you can see. So if we open it, there is the as you can see. There is description and action. One is which is this one, and then there is the input text template, which is here. Yeah. Then there is a there are two reveal elements, which either just show the text, which is get link, or which show the edit link input, and there is the edit link button. Yeah. So as here, it shows the text, or it shows the edit input and the different buttons. Okay, let's have a short look at the different elements. There is the get link, and get link just is a transclusion. As I told you, if the transclude widget doesn't find the field or the tiddler which it should transclude, it uses this text, which is part of the transclude body, to show it. And in this case, it's there is no description defined yet. Yeah? And if it finds the description, it just shows it. Okay, that's the get link. Then there is the edit link input, which is very similar to the other stuff. Edit link here. Yeah. It's just the edit text widget. Yeah, and it defines the text of a tiddler which is called new description. So this is the temporary tiddler and it contains the temporary text. Okay. There is the placeholder description. Pretty much standard. Then there is the edit link button. And the edit link button is here. And as you can see, it's a macro call to the toggle OK and cancel macro. And those macros are part of the toggle me macro tiddler, which will get its own video. So you can see there is a state because we want to reveal something. Then there is an open text, an OK text, a close text, and the delete text. In this case, we need to initialize it. I don't like this anymore because we have a look here. The toggle OK cancel macro has some predefined texts, and I'm not sure if I should really use this like this, because then you need, when you don't have any texts, then you need to overwrite them with spaces. I don't know. Then there are some icons. There is the edit button icon and the save button icon, which shown. Then the important thing here, there are two actions. There is the OK action. So if we click OK, and there is an action which is called open action or initialization action. So if we click this button, then it needs to do something. Because as I showed you already, if the description field doesn't exist, and if I, not this description field, if the new description tiddler doesn't exist, so the temporary tiddler, which is true at the very beginning, this edit button still needs to work. So if I click the button, it creates the temporary tiddler, as it did here, and copies the content from the description field into the temporary tiddler. So otherwise, this input would be empty. So that's the initialization field, which is called initLinkEditor, and initLinkEditor sets the field of the temporary tiddler to the value of the current tiddler description field. So this is important. Elements like this have to have an initialization action. And then there is the OK action, which just says set link, and set link just copies the value of new description into the field description of the current tiddler. Yeah, that's the whole functionality. You can play a little bit with it and then you'll see how it works. Have fun!